Hey everyone, it's me, your edutainer, Aran. 반갑습니다. 여러분의 에듀테이너 그리고 여러분의 배달은잠의 김아란입니다. Oh my goodness, it's been a while. Feels so good to be filming again. I've been really busy moving to America, catching up with Chris and teaching classes, so I'm so sorry if you've missed me. I missed you too. And we're going to catch up today. And to catch up, I'm going to do a little Q&A. I've gathered questions from my Instagram account because that's where I do Q&As from time to time. And you guys always have great questions and you guys love my answers. So I narrowed them down to like a couple hundred. Oh my goodness, there are so many questions that are good. So yeah, let's see how many we can answer today. Since we've got a lot to cover, let's begin.
요즘 갖고 싶은 거. Purity, diligence, humility, and passion. 언니 미국 생활 루틴은 어때?
Good, because I sleep enough. And when I wake up, I drink coffee, which is crazy. Me drinking coffee? Because I was never a coffee person. I never drank coffee at all because I never needed it. And I thought it just tasted so bitter. Like, why would you drink coffee? But getting old, I cannot wake up without a coffee. So I either make coffee or go get coffee. And I work. I teach. I correct my students' English sentences and I answer their questions. I encourage them. And I listen to music. I watch the sunset and just cuddle with Chris. And I cook. I cook every day. I've been making a lot of dishes and yeah, online shopping. And recently I've been reading my old prayer journals, and it's just amazing because I get to see like what God has done throughout the past years, and I'm really close to what I've been praying to become. It's actually just crazy and mind-blowing, and yeah, I look at my old prayers, I'm like, wow, Aran, you're good. Like, my prayers were so pure and so beautiful. So it's like I'm looking at someone else's prayers. Not that my prayers these days are bad or anything. I don't know. It's just so cool to look at what a younger Aran was praying for. And they're pretty cool. So I'm thinking about making a book with my prayers to guide people and, you know, pray with them and help them grow in prayers. So yeah, let me know if you are interested.
미국 생활의 장단점 궁금해. 말 그대로 생활적인 요소에서.
Well, first of all, I feel very free here. And that's so hard to explain because nothing in me changed. There's something about being in America that makes me feel so free. And I think that has to do with me feeling anonymous here. I feel anonymous and I love it. So for example, I don't have phone service. I don't have a phone number. Nobody can contact me. Well, people do contact me, you know, through KakaoTalk, Instagram, and Messenger. But it's so freeing having no phone number. As much as I love being connected and I am very active on social media, I love being disconnected as well. I stay home all the time. I'm such a homebody and I don't really meet people. Sometimes I'm in my PJs or, you know, I'm dressed really funnily and I look hideous, but I don't mind going to a supermarket or going to the mailroom because I know nobody knows me. It feels so good. Oh. But actually, there are people that know me. There are a lot of Koreans and even non-Koreans come say hi, like they know me and I love it, you know, at supermarkets and like at restaurants. I love getting to know you and talking with you. But just walking down the street and knowing that I won't be recognized feels good. Nobody knows my background, my history, my name, you know, my job. I feel like a new person. But I'm not a new person. Like, I'm the same, but I don't know. Just knowing that I have the opportunity to become a new person if I wanted to makes me feel really refreshed in a way. And just being with Chris, I laugh so much when I'm with Chris, and it's actually really fun. And I moved into a new house, and it has a high ceiling and big windows. Whew! Every day, looking at the sunset is just so, so amazing. So yeah, that's what I love about being in America. Plus, I really appreciate a lot of like restrooms, ramps, and different chairs and elevators for the differently abled. Instead of using the word the disabled, I would use the term the differently abled. But yeah, I really like that here. Something really inconvenient is I have to wait till, you know, you guys are up when I want to post something on Instagram. That's really silly, but yeah, I love interacting with you and I love posting stuff on Instagram, but I usually try to upload it when you guys are up. So the time difference, I just need to schedule things differently when I want to do that. But other than that, maybe having to tip, and like when you eat out, it's so expensive. I mean, living in Colorado here, it's so expensive. Like, oh my goodness, Colorado is such a famous and popular place. So it's really expensive. I mean, it's beautiful. The nature is amazing and gorgeous here. So it's really attractive for young people. You know, we've got the Rocky Mountains. You can go hike, you can go camp, you can go rock climb, and you can go rappelling and ski and snowboard and everything. It's so beautiful and very, very fun. We've got, you know, downtown Denver, and in Aurora, the city that I live in, we've got quite a few Korean restaurants, so it's a perfect city for me. But anyway, yeah, what a long answer. I'm such a TMT, too much talker. Oh my goodness.
인간관계에서 가장 중요한 게 뭐라고 생각해?
Well, I have two things. First, trust. I want to trust that people around me have good intentions for me. Not everything that they do might be good. Some of it could be hurtful or wrong or whatever, but I don't want to doubt their intention. Like, I want to trust that they intended something good. They intended something good for me. Like, they didn't intend to hurt me. They didn't intend to make me feel sad or, you know, bad or anything. You know, sometimes you get hurt by what other people say, but I never want to feel like, oh, did he try to hurt my feelings? Did she try to upset me? You know, I want to be able to trust that, like, oh, she said that because she doesn't know that I don't like that. Or he did it because he wanted to help me. You know, something like that. So having trust like that is really important. I never want to make my friends doubt my intention. And I always try to be a good person, having good intentions. Second, it is being truly happy for others' success. Listen, it is not as easy for some people. Some people get jealous. Some people make you feel uncomfortable. Some people make you feel like you shouldn't talk about your growth or success or your happiness. I've had some people that made me feel like I shouldn't talk about my dreams, what I have accomplished, or what is really going on in my life because I felt like they were not that happy for me. And, you know, on the other side, there are people that are actually genuinely excited for your success, and they genuinely want you to succeed and just go live the best life you can. And they're truly happy when something good happens to you. Like, hey, why didn't you tell me you accomplished this? Like, tell me about all you've done. Oh, wow, that's so awesome. I'm happy for you. Congratulations. Like, I can't wait for you to do more. You know, there are people like that, and I want to be one of them. And just having people like that is such a special, like, blessing. You know, in relationships, people say that it's important to be there for the other person when they're going through a tough time. And of course, it is really important. But I realize it's harder for people to be truly happy for the other person's happiness and success and growth. Being sad for someone is easier. See who's truly happy when you're successful, and that's your true friends.
영어 인문학 수업은 언제 또 할 계획이야? 한 번도 못 해봤는데 탐난다.
Yes. Yes. Whew, we literally provide everything you can imagine. I, first of all, teach a class live so I can chat with you and answer your questions live. And it's full of music. Like, I create songs on the spot to help you remember different phrases and sentences. And I show you YouTube videos and movie clips to help you understand the nuance of each sentence. And also to make learning edutaining. After the class is done, we give you the recorded one so you can review it over and over and keep it forever. And we also make a textbook based on what I teach, so you get really good quality PDF files, and I make an audio file so you can listen to the sentences every week, and we give you quizzes, and you guys send us like your own sentences, and we correct each sentence, and we answer all the questions you have regarding the classes. Whew, and more. Like, my teaching assistants, they help you personally set goals and really keep up with them and review the class and just pretty much everything. So I can't even tell you all. It's an amazing class. I think it is probably the best class you'll ever have. We're gonna have season 3 pretty soon. So if you're interested, please follow me on Instagram, because that's where I get to share all the information about it. And yeah, and turn on the notification here, because I may, you know, let you know on community, or do you want to see like highlight videos of my class on YouTube? Then I can maybe show you some parts and you can think about taking my course. But yeah.
MBTI 알려줘. Can you guess? I'm an ENFJ.
Were you right or were you wrong? What did you think I was? Please comment below. It is like 2% of the population. Barack Obama, Oprah Winfrey,
정의로운 사회운동가, 카리스마와 충만한 열정을 지닌 타고난 리더형, 진심으로 사람을 믿고 이끄는 지도자, 사회정의 구현을 위해 어려움에 맞서 싸우는 이. 당신의 사소한 행위는 잔잔한 물결처럼 서서히 퍼져나가 모든 이에게 영향을 줍니다. 정치가나 코치 혹은 교사와 같은 직군에서 흔히 볼 수 있습니다. 이들은 다른 이들로 하여금 그들의 꿈을 이루며 선한 일을 통하여 세상의 빛과 소금이 될 수 있도록 사람들을 독려합니다. 또한 자신뿐 아니라 더 나아가 살기 좋은 공동체를 만들기 위해 사람들을 동참시키고 이끄는 데에 큰 자부심과 행복을 느낍니다.
That is so me. That is like the definition of me. Pretty accurate.
행복을 위해 과감해지는 법이 뭘까?
Well, honey, you don't need to be bold to be happy. Happiness is already there. You just need to find it. You know, I think happiness is just all small things like petting a little dog, feeling the sunshine, drinking hot cocoa, just watching your favorite YouTube video. It's just all happiness. You don't need to be special to be happy.
Mm-hmm. 아기 계획은 아예 없는 거야? 아니면 일단 없는 거야? 실례가 안 된다면 답변 들을 수 있을까?
Yes. We don't plan to have children ever. And that is because before we got married, Chris brought up this idea of just loving the people that are already born instead of making new humans to love on. And that made perfect sense to me. So we discussed adoption and we are thinking about fostering, but mainly I think my mission is to teach and mentor people. So I consider you guys my children in a way. And Chris wants to be a researcher and a doctor, and he wants to devote his life to medicine. So yeah, just using our talents and time, money and energy for our neighbors, pretty much. And so far, so good. But recently I've used an app to, you know, kind of like see what our future babies will look like. And they are pretty good looking. So I'm really tempted, and wasting Chris's genes is kind of a big deal. So that's just one thing that I'm sad about. But yeah, I feel pretty good about my decision. I mean, if I get pregnant, of course, I'll just become a mom and I'll be thankful. But I know some people are going to tell me like, Aran, you need to have children. That's what God wants. But no. No. God wants you to love. And there are so many people that need teachers, sisters, moms, dads, neighbors, friends. God wants all of us to be their friends and their neighbors and their family. And I'm choosing to use my resources for that. And I'm sure God is just as happy when I do that. So, just saying.
아란이가 지금의 영어 실력을 갖는 데 가장 큰 영향을 준 경험은 뭐야? 토플, 미국 수업, 노숙인과의 생활, 미국 친구, 드림?
So, Dream is what I created to teach people English and worldviews and the Bible and all that stuff for free. So that was Dream, like giving, which was my dream as well. But yeah, what helped me the most is I would say speaking English with native English speakers every single day for a whole year. I was a junior in college, and as a lot of you know, I was an exchange student in America, and I did not understand much English at all, but I had plans literally like every day. I always hung out with American friends, and I would attend everything that I could to mingle and just, you know, meet new people. That helped so much, and that's what I recommend all the time when someone asks me, hey, how can I improve my English? Like, go talk to a native English speaker. And I open classes where you can talk to an English speaker, and all of them are currently sold out, but I'll let you know when I get a spot available for you. But other than that, yes, living in the homeless shelter, my English improved like crazy as well. Every single day for like 10 weeks, I communicated with American staff and American children. So volunteering there, I could physically feel like my tongue just getting so, so, so fast, and my listening skills improved a lot then as well.
아란이의 마음 안에는 신이 있는 것 같아. 무기력하고 우울할 때 당신의 영상을 보면서 힘이 났어.
I love you. And yes, God is in me, and God loves you as well. Thank you. All right, this is it for today. Thank you so much for watching. And if you have more questions, please feel free to comment below. I would love to answer your questions in the future. Also, I think it'll be really fun if you chose a couple of the questions that I answered and answer them in the comment section. I would love to read your answer and learn about you. Plus, please share with me what's going on in your life. How are you doing? Is there something that I should pray for, or is there something that I should celebrate with you? I would love to know. So let's talk more in the comment section. And I look forward to meeting you again. So stay tuned. Then I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!